that given there's no military base, there's no barracks, there's no active military presence in Menomonee Falls that we know of, to be sending one of these special military absentee ballots to a standalone residence?
I've sent military ballots to standalone residents to those who are military before.
Adams asked the same question to Shorewood Village Clerk Toya Harrell.
You can sidestep the normal security protocol if you go through my vote, indicate you're a military voter to get one of these absentee ballots.
Anything's possible.
Zapata's former boss, Election Commission Executive Director Claire Woodall, is expected to take the stand this week. The trial expected to last multiple days. A proposed $252 million Milwaukee Public Schools referendum would impact residents' tax bill. Senior advisor to the MMAC, Tim Sheehy, tells WTMJ homeowners and renters would feel the raise.
Milwaukee, over the last 12 months, has had the second fastest growing rent increases at about 4%. And our survey of 50 large property owners who have rental units, 90% of them say they're going to pass on the cost of the property tax increase to their renters.
Meanwhile, MPS Superintendent Dr. Keith Posley telling Wisconsin's Afternoon News last week the referendum is necessary to maintain services the district brought back in 2020.
The reason we're going is the idea that we want to maintain services that we have started, the work that we have started since 2020, from the first referendum where we were able to add back art, music, physical education, library media specialists, smaller class sizes, counselors, and we are maintaining that.
The referendum will be on Milwaukee residents' ballots April 2nd. The UN's human rights chief saying today Israel's restrictions on humanitarian aid for Gaza may amount to a starvation tactic that could be a war crime. Secretary of State Antony Blinken in the Philippines.
100%, the totality of the population is in need of humanitarian assistance. Compare that to Sudan, about 80% of the population there is in need of humanitarian assistance. Afghanistan, about 70%. So again, this only underscores both the urgency, the imperative of making this the priority.
U.S. continuing to push for more humanitarian assistance to Gaza. And Kyle Rittenhouse being asked to appear at Kent State University.
Kent State is where National Guard troops killed four students and wounded others during a 1970 Vietnam War protest. Kyle Rittenhouse was asked to talk about defending his Second Amendment right by the president of the local chapter of Turning Point USA, which advocates conservative politics, Bradley Seymour.
I think it's also important to have it for when the government isn't doing enough.
Kent State says it won't intervene, calling it free speech. Chuck Sievertson, ABC News.
Time for news about your money. The WTMJ Annex Wealth Management market update at this hour. The Dow Jones up 75 points to 38,865. Meanwhile, the S&P 500 is off 10 points this morning to 5,139. The Nasdaq, meanwhile, down 105 points to 15,999. It's a great time for your retirement and investment strategy review from a fee-only fiduciary. Go to annexwealth.com and click on the Get Started button now. News is sponsored by Holiday Automotive at Highway 23 in Fond du Lac. Holiday Automotive, it's worth the trip. Sports, traffic, and weather coming up next. Siding Unlimited, WTMJ News Times, 904.
Fond du Lac, where the Spring Forward sales event is your ticket to smile, save, and drive inspired this spring and beyond. Hey, right now, well-qualified buyers can lock in rates as low as 0% APR on favorites, including the exhilarating all-wheel drive Mazda CX-30 and CX-50 turbo models. Connect with Holiday and get more Mazda for your money and more for your trade on the new or Mazda-certified pre-owned car or crossover that's right for you. Choose from an impressive selection and enjoy Team Holiday's transparent, simplified buying approach and genuine guest care. It's the stuff that delights and makes fans of drivers from all over the Badger State. You'll be in great hands with Wisconsin's number one Mazda dealer and its number one Mazda certified pre-owned dealer on your side. Accolades are per Mazda North American Operations Performance and Zone Sales Records for 2023. Find yours and discover the difference at Holiday Mazda, Highway 41 and 23 in Fond du Lac, and online at holidaymazda.com. It's worth the trip.
If you love authentic Mexican food, this is for you. WTMJ's John Mercier here. I love the Mine Shaft restaurant in Hartford because it's locally family owned and it is super affordable and delicious. This is new and it's amazing. Today and every Tuesday, the Mine Shaft presents their all-you-can-eat authentic Mexican buffet for under 10 bucks. Seriously, it's all-you-can-eat. It's just $9.99. Wow. It's the best Tuesday dining value anywhere. Your kids and grandkids can safely play in that $2 million game room. quietly tucked away from the dining area while you finish up your meal. The Mind Chef's all-you-can-eat Mexican buffet is under $10. Kids under 3 always eat for free. Come early from 2 till 5, Monday through Thursday. Beers, cocktails, and appetizers are half price. The Mineshaft in beautiful downtown Hartford and right off the interstate in Oshkosh. Try the All-You-Can-Eat Tuesday Mexican Buffet today from 11 a.m. for under $10. MineshaftRestaurant.com. Big food, big fun. It's the Mineshaft.
Time for a WTMJ sports update from the Gruber Law Office's One Call That's All sports desk. Multiple outlets reporting Brewers prospect Jackson Churio is set to make the opening day roster. In December, Churio signed an 8-year, $82 million extension, the most ever for a player yet to appear in the major leagues. The crew back in action this afternoon against the Guardians in Arizona. Our coverage begins at 2:55 right here on WTMJ. Checking your roads, your WTMJ Johnson & Sons paving time saver traffic. We've got no major incidents on the system, just a couple of broken down vehicles. We'll be a bit slow as you're heading through the construction zone on 894 West from 27th Street all the way to about, looks like that's going all the way to 60th Street on your route west. Also eastbound 94 from about 76th Street through the stadium to 35th. It's going to be a bit of a tap on the brakes there. And then southbound on 43 from just north of Hampton Avenue down to around Keith. It'll be a bit of a slow go there as well. The rest of the system overall looking okay.
Traffic is sponsored by Ken Michaels Furniture in Brookfield, Greenfield, or downtown Milwaukee. Milwaukee Mattress, where top quality mattresses are priced hundreds less than premium national mattress brands. Found exclusively at Ken Michaels Furniture in Brookfield, Greenfield, and downtown Milwaukee.
The WTMJ 5-day forecast. Cloudy skies this morning. It will become partly cloudy, staying windy throughout the day. A high of 51, gusts up to 35 miles per hour possible. Mostly clear tonight, down to 25. Mostly sunny and breezy. Chilly for your Wednesday, just a high of 36. 34 and partly cloudy Thursday. Then the snow moves in late Thursday night into the morning on Friday. Could see an accumulation possible. A high of 35. Partly cloudy and 33 for your Saturday. Right now in Madison, clouds and 30 degrees. It's 33 in Green Bay, 28 in Waukesha, and in Milwaukee, clouds and 34 degrees. I'm Adam Roberts, signing Unlimited WTMJ News Times 908.
Good morning, Wisconsin. So let's pour that coffee and talk to some experts about what's going on in Milwaukee, Madison, Washington, and beyond. Broadcasting live from the Annex Wealth Management Studios at The Avenue in beautiful downtown Milwaukee. It's the Political Power Hour on WTMJ. Here's your host, Steve Scafidi.
Should we talk about the government?
I say yes. Welcome to the Tuesday edition. Let me get right to it. My guest every other Tuesday, Christian Snyder, author, columnist, National Review Online. Great podcast that he's part of, along with his partner, Scott Bertram. 50 years of SNL, author of 1916, the blog, antiknowledge.com. Great, great book. If you're going on an airplane flight, either one of those books, great reads. Christian Snyder joins us on the Tri-County Contracting Hotline. Good morning, Christian Snyder.
Good morning. I'm back from my my mission to try to find Kate Middleton.
And?
Evidently, we found her. There's video of her. I'm not sure who was gone longer, Kate Middleton or Chris Middleton, because he was gone for like maybe they were hanging out together.
Chris is
like,
back, baby.
He's back, but he was gone for what, 2 months? It's like his foot fell off and he had to grow a new foot.
Yeah, it was a serious ankle sprain. All right, let's get right to it. Is the former president Christian Snyder? Is he misunderstood when the bloodbath comment gets put out there on a campaign platform?
Yeah, so I've heard a bunch of people, my friends actually, go online and say, you know, it actually helps Donald Trump when people overstate what he said, like over the weekend when he said, you know, it's going to be a bloodbath for America if he doesn't get elected. And people were complaining, well, this is a hoax because he was talking about the auto industry. A couple of things. First of all, if you're uncomfortable with your president, former president, using the term bloodbath, then maybe don't pick a candidate who has actually encouraged a bloody insurrection.
Right. Right.
I mean, that's just a tip. Secondly, he used the term bloodbath he says he's clearly talking about the auto industry, but then he says that will be the least of it, and then he talks about there will be a bloodbath for the whole country. So he had kind of shifted to talking about the country as a whole. Anyway, it's stupid to parse what this lunatic says, but he was clearly talking about the country as a whole and not the auto industry. Anyway, so the Trump supporters are saying, well, so it's out of context. But when you put it in the context of the entire speech, what he had said from beginning to end, it's even worse, because he later in the speech, he talks about how he's going to pardon the January 6th freedom fighters, and he calls them, quote, unbelievable patriots.
And hostages.
There's some weird
hostages.
Hostages. And then there's some weirdo thing where he salutes while they're playing the January 6th national anthem or something like that.
Right,
so,
right.
You know, it's a song made up of the January 6th, quote unquote, hostages singing or whatever. It's just all lunacy.
Well, it's talking points. I mean, he said before words or phrases like big, big trouble if he doesn't get elected, bedlam in this country. He's a guy that makes threats. He couches them in sort of unique ways, although I don't know that he has a master of the vocabulary enough to know that he's doing that. But he's certainly very willing to engage in some of this rhetoric and fire up, he thinks, his base.
Right, he'll tell you exactly what he's thinking and what he wants to do. You remember back in 2020, for months before the election, he was saying, "If I don't get elected, then it's obviously vote fraud or it's rigged," and he did that for months and months. And then finally, when he did lose, that's when he sicked all the January 6th people on the Capitol. He tells you what he's going to do. It's not a secret. So when he says stuff like this, then we should believe him. How many times does he have to say that he's going to try to overturn the Constitution before we believe that that's what he's actually trying to do, especially since he's already tried to do it?
Yeah, you know, if I had a buck for every time someone said, "Why are you talking about January 6th? Oh, I don't know, because President Trump mentions it in like every campaign speech that he does, and how he thinks these people are hostages. His term, or, you know, proud patriots, you know, using people in prison who are singing a version of the national anthem as his anthem when he comes out on these stages. I don't know. That seems like something we should be talking about for a candidate for president.
It's not just the January 6th people, too, because when he does this, it's a message to anybody else out there, like, hey, there's a pardon waiting for you if you do something crazy to try to support me in my presidency. I mean, he's already pardoned Paul Manafort and kind of, you know, all these other crew of undesirables that have tried to help him politically. So by saying he's going to pardon the January 6th people, it's a message to anybody in the future that wants to try to help him through maybe extra legal means that he'll be there and he'll have their back.
I don't know if it was our friend Charlie Sykes or somebody else in that world of sort of communication that put a list together of all of the former staff, former cabinet members, people aligned with the former president who have now come out and said, do not elect this person as the next president of the United States. Why is that so hard for most Republicans to understand, at least if we judge by the results of the primaries we've had so far?
Yeah, it is a long list of former cabinet secretaries and administration people who have said they would never reelect him. And they're the people that know him the best. For the people out there listening who are Trump supporters, I mean, who do you think knows him better, you or the people that actually worked under him for years and years who are warning us against him? And this list has been out there a long time. The list was out there long before Nikki Haley started running against him and dropped out. So, you know, we had the chance to pick somebody else and chose not to because, you know, people don't want to hear the truth, I guess.
Christian Steiner, our guest, as he is every other Tuesday here on WTMJ on the Political Power Hour. We'll take a break. We're going to talk about the other side, Kamala Harris, Joe Biden, current presidents, and how that campaign and state of the race as well. Christian Steiner, our guest, more after this on WTMJ.
Tony Drake here from Drake & Associates. Big news! Our Retirement Ready radio show is moving to a new time slot. Catch us at noon every Saturday. At Drake & Associates, we craft tailor-made plans that not only meet your financial needs, but align seamlessly with your unique lifestyle. Tune in at noon on Saturdays and get retirement ready.
Drake & Associates LLC is an independent investment advisory firm that offers a variety of different investment vehicles. This commercial is provided for informational purposes only and should not be construed as individual investment advice. Drake & Associates LLC does not provide legal or tax advice.
Hey, this is WTMJ Steve's Committee for the Bath Authority. If your bathroom shower is old, outdated, mold, mildew, seen that? Broken tiles? You got to call my friends at the Bath Authority. The Bath Authority provides the highest quality bathroom remodeling products, along with a best-in-class, world-class customer experience. They're modern, durable tubs and showers designed with an exclusive high-tech polymer liner. What does that mean? Low maintenance, resistant to that mold and mildew, easy to clean. Who doesn't love that? And lasts for decades. Do what I did. You're their priority at the Bath Authority, thebathauthority.com. One more time, thebathauthority.com. A better bath awaits.
For over a century, local broadcasting has evolved with the needs of the community. We move past the stigmas of opinion journalism and bring the most relevant news online, on air, and on the go. You have trusted us with your news, sports, weather, and entertainment. Trust us to keep moving with you. Text radio to 52886 and tell Congress local broadcasting is here to stay.
For over 75 years, Running Stores have earned the reputation for quality brands, fair value, and hometown-friendly service. Now Runnings is bringing those same values to you. Runnings is now open in your community. Find the widest variety of everything you and your family need for your home, on the farm, and in the outdoors. Runnings is proud to live, work, and serve in local communities across the Midwest, the Northeast, and America's heartland. Runnings is your new home, farm, and outdoor store. We look forward to seeing you soon. Learn more about us at Runnings.com.
Author and columnist Christian Slater, our guest. Christian, the other side of the tickets, Joe Biden, current president, number 46. Kamala Harris, what's going on there?
Well, they have her out on the campaign trail.
Is that good or bad? Is that good or bad?
So, typically the way presidential campaigns are run is that the president will be out there, you know, kind of being the more moderate voice. The one trying to collect the middle, if you will. And then you have the vice president out there who's kind of the attack dog who will go out and do the more hardline things to try to keep, the party faithful at bay. This actually happened in 2016 when Donald Trump picked Mike Pence because, for all the Republicans that may have had questions about Trump, he had Pence out there to comfort the people that wanted a traditional Republican, at least as the backup. So that's typically how it works. I think Joe Biden should actually flip the way that they're doing it right now. I think Joe Biden should be the one out there kind of doing the red meat type of stuff. Mm-hmm. And Kamala Harris should be the one out there being more moderate and not scaring, the voters in the middle. Because one of the big problems that Joe Biden has is that I don't think anybody expects him to be able to serve out another full term. And so people are worried about who his vice president is going to be. So I think Kamala Harris needs to soften the image a little bit. They need to work harder and try to make her more palatable rather than having her, go visit abortion clinics, mm-hmm. as they did last week. I just think they need to go all in on trying to make Kamala Harris as palatable as possible to American voters, rather than having her play the traditional role of, kind of being the hardline red meat type of vice presidential candidate.
So I asked you, or I teased it in the opening to the break there. State of the race: Trump doing very well in the swing states. It's close in Wisconsin and Pennsylvania. He's got pretty decent margins in the other swing states that are going to decide this election. I've said for a while, I almost don't get what the polls are telling us, because I talk to a lot of people, I read a lot about the election, and I hear what people are saying, and there seems to be a couple of things that would work against the former president. One, suburban women. Two, just the abortion, women's health care issue, and then there's a lot of other things, including the conduct of the former president. But yet the polling, Christian, as far as the state of the race goes, looks very favorable for the former president.
Right. It's true. In the states where he needs to win the most, it looks like he is ahead. But, I mean, again, we have a long way to go and a lot of court cases and a lot more news to be made before then. Of course, none of that has even dented him. In fact, it's actually made Trump more powerful, more popular.
Yeah.
Because of all the people that think that he's under fire from the Biden administration, which is not really true. But it's going to be wild, and we don't know how this stuff is going to shake out.
What do you make of the president, former president, saying he can't get the funds together to appeal his conviction? And I think he's got to like next Monday or Monday or Tuesday, early next week. And I watched a lot of commentary last night on what would happen next, and it seems to be not a one opinion. It seems to be a multitude of opinions. It could go a lot of different ways, including, you know, a seizure, which is not easy for government agencies to do, especially when you're talking about the assets of Donald Trump. And then including like a fire sale. I'm not sure where the story's going to go.
Right. So he can't find a bank to help him post his bond in the New York case. And because banks don't typically back con men.
typically don't.
Right. Basically, Donald Trump is a legal defense fund with a candidate attached to it. like the whole reason that he's running is to try to stay out of prison or try to keep from having to pay all these judgments. So he's, you know, soaking little old ladies for campaign contributions so he can pay his legal fees. In any normal political environment, that would be bad for a candidate, but he's completely switched things around now. Whether he wins or loses this year, he's already kind of won because he's completely transformed American politics. You see all these people now who behave like Trump, who use his talking points, and I don't think that's going away. I mean, you have all the people who are sucking up to him, trying to be his vice presidential candidate, people like Elise Stefanik and J.D. Vance and people like that. I think they're here to stay because Trump has won everything. He's changed everything for good.
It's a big question, and we'll end with this. Why do you think that's the case? Why has this happened? I had somebody tell me the other day, a Republican strategist, it's just his personality. That's the only difference between him and everybody. Just his personality. I said, you're crazy. But why is this happening?
I think people went so long not seeing the government fulfill their needs or what they needed. So they figured, well, what we really need is like a strong man, somebody who can really get things done just by sheer force of his personality. And you saw Elon Musk this morning actually tweet that.
Yeah.
Like, so he's still on board. Is like the only way we need to get spending down is to have a leader who is really strong. And that's not really how government works. I agree. You obviously need somebody with you know, strong beliefs and strong feelings, and I'm not sure Trump has those as far as how government is funded, but you know, you can't just take somebody with a strong personality and make them president and have them get all this stuff done. There's actually checks and balances. There's ways to get things done, and I don't think people really understood that, so they just took the loudest and the loudest guy who's basically a hand grenade to the political system that they didn't like. And so
single-handedly destroyed confidence in nearly every U.S. institution, single-handedly destroyed confidence elections, and trying to go forward with that reality that has moved beyond perception to reality. I hear it all the time, including on this station, just people saying stuff that's like, wow, that was not something I expected to hear. It's the new reality.
Yeah, it's Republican friends of yours who, when you realize that they've gone Trump, it's like almost they've been bitten by a zombie, and you're like, oh no, it's gotten you too. It's like in the zombie movies when you realize somebody's been bitten. But I don't know. Hopefully, we'll be back soon.
All right, we need what's the guy's Walking Dead? What's the character's name? Rick. Rick Grimes. We need a Rick Grimes is what we need. Christian Snyder, are you prepared to be our Rick Grimes? I think you can handle that.
Absolutely not.
All right. That was not an enthusiastic response, so we'll pick someone else. All right. Christian Seider, we'll do it again in a couple of weeks.
All right. Thanks.
All right. Thank you, man. All right. We'll take a break here. We got news coming at the bottom of the hour. Then special guest, Jeremy Janine, is going to fill in for Dan Schaefer today, although Jeremy Janine doesn't need to play second fiddle to anybody. He's got a breaking story that we're going to talk about. Quick break.
Come see Thanalysis live from Potawatomi Casino Hotel on Friday, March 22nd.
Hey, welcome to another Thanalysis show. And who do we have coming up in today's podcast?
Be there for the first ever live show for Thanasis as he's joined by his brother, none other than the Greek freak, Giannis Antetokounmpo.
I took off my shoes and I was like, go crazy, go hoop. That's all it was.
Get your tickets now at taliveshow.com. Thanalysis live at Potawatomi Casino Hotel on March 22nd. taliveshow.com.
Hey, this is WTMJ's Tease Committee for Adair Floors, ADAIR, yes, floors and remodeling. They don't just do floors. Located on South 27th Street in Franklin, that's that border between Oak Creek and Franklin, south of Rawson, north of Highway 100, Ryan Road. Their design team worked with Kathy and I, my wife, to replace our basement landing area floor. Looks beautiful now. That could be your reality. They help with flooring, remodeling needs, home or business. Family-owned and operated, and that's important. They did my kitchen floor 20-plus years ago. Still looks fantastic. Owner Rob said, wow, that thing is held up. I said, absolutely. Right there in Franklin, stop in, tell them Scafidi sent you, or visit them online at Adair, A-D-A-I-R, floors.com.
CertaPro Painters know how important your home is to you. I know how good a job they do because CertaPro Painters did our house. WTMJ's John Mercier here. It was professional, it was easy, it was quick, and it was efficient. And so affordable. It's CertaPro Painters. They get the job done right, even those hard-to-reach places they will knock out of the ballpark. Free estimates, reliable communication, professional painting, all at the right price. When choosing a painting professional, the choice is simple. Choose happy. Choose CertaPro Painters. Choose the team we went with, CertaPro Painters.
Hey, 620 WTMJ fans, Gary Austin here for my good friends over at Best Electric Services. They're family-owned and operated and have been serving you for over 50 years. No job is too big or too small. Whether it's making panel upgrades to your home, tuning up your generator, installing electric vehicle charging, or residential service calls, Best Electric provides quality services at fair prices. They are experienced and licensed electrical contractors ready to get to work. Connect with the best. Best Electric Service. Find out more at bestelect.com.
Spectrum Business is made to work like your small business. Made to do it all with fast, ultra-reliable internet, phone, and mobile services. And made to work with a small business budget. Get 600 megabit per second business internet for just $49.99 a month for 1 year with select bundles. Plus, get an unlimited mobile line for free. Visit spectrum.com/work to lock in this deal now. Learn more at spectrum.com/work. Restrictions apply. Services not available in all areas.
WTMJ's Vince Vitrano for Orthopedic Associates of Wisconsin. Injuries happen, but you don't have to play in pain or stay on the sidelines. Whether it's your kids dealing with a sports injury, college athletes, or the rest of us weekend warriors, the experts at Orthopedic Associates of Wisconsin will quickly diagnose your problem, lay out a treatment plan that works for you, and get you back in the game. They fixed my knee. My mother-in-law is back on the dance floor with a new hip. These are the experts you can trust. Visit orthowisconsin.com.
We'll get to the bottom hour news here in a second. I want to give you my show pool for the day. Quickly, let me find it. All right. Former President Donald Trump says he can't secure a bond for $450 million civil fraud judgment against him. Do you think he's telling the truth? Yes, it's unreasonable at 24%. No, he's a liar, 26%. Don't care either way, 42%. Got a lot of votes already. We just started, 220 votes. Interesting, don't care. I'm not sure what that's telling me. Is that people checked out from politics? Too early for November conversation. It's actually a conversation that's going to be very relevant as early as next week when that deadline happens in that judgment. And the president's former president, Donald Trump, is going to have to either sell some assets or his assets will be seized, whatever that means. And it's not a fun thing for government agencies to do that. It's a hassle they don't like to get involved in. But at some point, $450 million and counting every day is a big number that the former president will have to face. After the break, Jeremy Janine from Urban Milwaukee will join us. Breaking news story that we're going to cover. But right now, our news time here at WTMJ is 9:30. ABC News is next.
ABC News. I'm Sherry Preston. The first over-the-counter birth control pill called O-Pill is now available nationwide. Here's ABC's Ariel Reshef.
Now you can add birth control to your Amazon cart. O-Pill is officially available online without a prescription. Many health officials see this as a major step toward expanding access to this medication, with the American Academy of Pediatrics applauding this decision. One pack will cost $19.99, a three-month supply $49.99, or $89.99 for 6 months.
Six former law enforcement officers who pleaded guilty to a long list of state and federal charges for torturing two black men last year will be sentenced by a federal judge starting today. Police say the six men broke into a home without a warrant and assaulted Michael Corey Jenkins and Eddie Parker with stun guns and other objects. Former Trump administration trade advisor Peter Navarro begins his four-month prison sentence today for contempt of Congress. Former President Trump is of now unable to come up with the $464 million bond needed. Sherry Preston, ABC News.
Signing and limited WTMJ News Times 931. Early in-person voting begins today for the April 2nd spring election and presidential preference. If you live in Milwaukee, most voting locations are open daily until March 30th. The Zeidler Municipal Building, Capitol Drive Voting Center, and various library locations also open on weekends. While the primary candidates for president are set with their party's nominations, there are multiple referenda, mayoral, and local races on the ballots. The man with whom missing 3-year-old Elijah Vu was staying with before his disappearance has requested his child neglect charge be dismissed. Jesse Vang requesting the dismissal Monday and also now has been appointed an attorney, which could allow the case against him and Vu's mother, Katrina Bauer, to move forward. Vang and Bauer both face charges of chronic neglect of a child but have not been charged in Vu's disappearance. Meanwhile, authorities in Two Rivers Monday confirming a red and white plaid blanket found 4 miles from Vu's last known location does belong to the child. And Marquette University will reduce its budget by $31 million over the next 7 years. Officials say the school faces the situation partly because the students' need for more financial aid has increased. Nearly 75% of Marquette's revenue goes to tuition and room and board. Time for news about your money, the WTMJ Annex Wealth Management Market Update at this hour. The Dow Jones up 96 points to 38,886. The other majors in the red, the S&P 500 down 13 to 5,137. And the NASDAQ is off 117 points to 15,986. It's a great time for your retirement and investment strategy review from a fee-only fiduciary. Go to annexwealth.com, click the Get Started button now. Checking the roads, your WTMJ Johnson & Sons paving time saver traffic. Right now, still just a little bit slow on 43 from about Hampton Avenue south to Keefe right now. A lot of the other delays have worked themselves out on 94 and on 894 west. So the system overall looking pretty good at this hour. No other major incidents or delays. And your WTMJ 5-day forecast for today. Clouds becoming partly cloudy, windy as well, a high of 51, mostly clear 25 tonight. Sunny on Wednesday, chilly, a high of 36, partly cloudy Thursday and 34. Then the snow makes its way in for Thursday night into Friday. Could see a mixture of rain and freezing rain and snow to the south, a high of 35, partly cloudy and 33 on Saturday. Right now in Prairie du Chien, clouds in 36, Menominee Falls, cloudy in 32, and in Milwaukee, clouds starting to break up a bit and 35 degrees. I'm Adam Roberts, signing Unlimited WTMJ News Times 934.
An intimate evening with David Foster and Catherine McPhee. Performing hit after hit, live on stage. May 2nd at the Pabst Theater. Tickets are on sale now at PabstTheaterGroup.com. Don't miss David Foster and Catherine McPhee together live.
Hey, this is WTMJ's Steve Kiffey for Heiser Automotive. I love talking about Heiser. I'm in the last days of getting to drive the 2023 Ford Explorer XLT. We'll be turning that one in, getting a new vehicle to drive. This one is a beauty, four-wheel drive, perfect for our crazy Wisconsin weather. Might get crazier this week, actually. Beautiful, cool Atlas blue metallic color. Great gas mileage, 23 combined city and highway. Awesome for an SUV. Some of these great features. Heated exterior mirrors. You don't realize how important that is until it gets icy. Keyless access. Heated front seats. Used them this morning. It was chilly out there. All the safety features, all the technology you expect with Ford. Find out for yourself. Go to one of their great locations in southeastern Wisconsin or to Heiser.com. and find out all the great pre-owned and new vehicles. That's why they say every day, and I say it all the time, today's your day.
Vince Vitrano for Absolute Comfort, HVAC and Electrical. I'm joined by Nicole. She and her husband, Brent, own the company. Nicole, why should folks call you guys?
Because we treat your home like ours. That means honest and high-quality work. We want you to be a part of our family. We're there for your emergencies when you need it. But most important to us is building a long-term relationship for all of your HVAC and electrical needs.
Absolute Comfort, HVAC and Electrical, 262-664-9284. AbsoluteComfortWY.com.
Oh, we got a good guest this half hour. Jeremy Janine, he's the president and co-founder of Urban Milwaukee. I've seen you around the building. I know you've been on some of those shows. You were on with Jeff Sherman not too long ago, host of the Upswing. Was it Jeff?
I think that's the one show I haven't been on yet.
Really? What show were you on?
I was with Kristen. I was with Greg. I was with John.
States. Yeah, midday. Okay, I'm my air, but I saw you in the building. The reason you're on today, we talked that we wanted to get you on the show before this story broke, but big story breaking. And it has to do with the Department of Public Works, some city workers who robbed, essentially from the taxpayers, and, oh, by the way, they blew that cash, a significant amount of cash, at the casino. Tell the story.
Yeah, I've been following the story since 2022 when I got a tip that, hey, this is coming, and I expected something very complex, and it's... It has a level of complexity, but it's also a very simple scheme, so it's easy to see why eventually they got caught. In the summer of 2022, two city workers that were in charge of fleet services for DPW, so this is a department with hundreds and hundreds of people, many locations, every city garbage truck you see.
A lot of assets.
Yes, just they have stuff, and they have an inventory of stuff, and they have multiple people that are in charge of buying new stuff and then disposing of it, and they're supposed to sell it at an auction or scrap it in the case that it's something that, you know, gets in a crash or something. Well, in this case, they bypassed all that and sold it for cash to some people. And they not only sold it for cash, but they sold it for less than it was worth. And then to add insult to injury, they then would go buy money orders for about 10% of what they sold it for. So they kind of robbed the taxpayers twice there.
Right, yeah.
And they kept that excess cash, and they both now signed federal felony plea agreements. The last point that they had to stipulate to was that they were excessively visiting Pottawatomie Hotel and Casino, which is just down the street from where they were doing this.
To the tune of, I hope I got this right, $357,511 in fines? And
that is not actually a fine. That's simply the restitution.
That's how much they think they spent there?
No. The plea agreement doesn't give a specific number for how much they spent.
Okay.
If you add up the different numbers, it's clear based on what was reported and what the people that they actually sold the stuff to told the city that they paid for it. And then they could produce valid paperwork that they were getting quite the steal. But then this fraudulent paperwork was, so Steve, I'm going to sell you something for $1,000 and then I'm going to report it for $100.
Right.
I'm going to pocket $900. That amount of pocketing adds up to at least $100,000. And the plea agreement says we stole at least $100,000. The city, though, should have received about $350,000.
That's where I got that number. Now, we're talking about 22 pallets of material, according to your reporting, 6 pieces of welding equipment, which is not cheap, and a new replacement fuel tank for a city-owned truck. All of these things owned by the taxpayers.
And that was just one day. They went to work on a Saturday, my anniversary, happy anniversary to my wife, and we're just hauling it out the door to this unidentified individual known only in the report as RG. The report doesn't suggest that that individual is going to face criminal charges, but it does, and I'm doing the air quotes right now, note he made a significant profit because he was getting stuff for under market value and reselling it.
So the employees have been fired. I think they got that, gleaned that from your story. They obviously accepted this plea. They're facing pretty significant jail prison time, like I think 5 to 11 years, something like that. Felony charges, right?
Yep.
How was this found out?
The best I understand it, you hear about those whistleblowers hotlines. You think, well, does anything ever come of those? In this case, it did. They were turned in by one of their own coworkers, it sounds like.
So this is a bigger question. Do you think, or have you heard your reporting indicate from your sources, whoever they are, that this stuff has happened before that's outside of the scope of this specific, these specific individuals?
I've never gotten the sense that something like this has happened before. And to establish who these two people are, Kyle Hepp and Kelly Whitmore Bailing. They were both new to these jobs.
Interesting.
Kyle was a manager. Kelly was an assistant to execute the scheme. It took both of them working together to produce these fraudulent records and then record them. But Kyle didn't get to the department until April of 2022. I believe maybe it was April 2021. But they were carrying out the scheme in the summer of 2022. The one thing I have heard is that with a department this large, sometimes purchasing doesn't end up in execution. So I occasionally get tips that, hey, the city bought all this stuff and it's not using it.
Right.
Now, the stuff's theoretically not going bad. It could be used in the future. That's more government issues with bureaucracy.
Any comment from leadership in the city of Milwaukee?
I have to be totally honest. I didn't start working on the story, at least writing this version.
Right? Yeah.
At 9 p.m. last night, I have a 3-year-old at home who decided that's all the number of hours she wants to sleep at night now. And
that's
so
a reality everyone has to face when they have kids.
And I'm facing it right now. I didn't start working on it till very late. I intend to do a full follow-up today to get a sense of, both at the Common Council, what ordinance changes they might push through in terms of...
And that meeting's happening today.
That's happening right now. I'm going to leave here and head over there. What ordinance changes? I think it's fairly obvious that any DPW equipment that is going to get disposed in the future should come with an auction-only process. Can't dispose of it any other way. No cash sales. Because the city was accepting these money orders on its books.
Yeah.
And I assume
that's
made
troubling.
It, yeah. That, you know, money orders are unusual. I'm sure many of the listeners are like, what's a money order?
And I will ask Mayor Kevler-Johnson about this specific incidences when I have him on the show next. We'll take a break. I want to ask about what other things you're reporting on, including maybe the RNC, some of the security stuff going on there. Jeremy Janine from Urban Milwaukee, our guest on the Tuesday edition of the Political Power Hour on WTMJ.
Wait now or wait a little longer. You may have just increased your lifetime income by tens of thousands of dollars. That's how Social Security can work for you. The longer you wait, the more money you may get. Deciding when to start taking your Social Security benefits is one of the most important retirement decisions you'll make. Our team at Drake & Associates can show you the options and help make the right decision for your situation. You spent decades paying in. Optimize what comes out. Drake & Associates can help you squeeze every penny out of your Social Security benefits. Claim your free retirement ready toolkit that has guides on Social Security. To get our complimentary toolkit, call or text SS to 414-409-9982. That's calling or texting SS to 414-409-9982.
Investment advisory services provided by Drake & Associates, LLC, an SEC-registered investment advisor. Insurance products are offered through a separate company, Loft Financial Advisory Group, LLC, a Wisconsin insurance agency. Clients are under no obligation to purchase any recommended insurance products.
Hey, this is WTMJ Steve Cafferty for Advent. I had snoring issues. Yes, hard to believe, right? Kept my wife, Kathy, up at night. Probably woke me up a lot more than I realized. That leads to, of course, tired, grouchy mornings. Hopefully not. I did something about it. I went to Advent for a quick 30-minute visit. They put me at ease. We did a really simple sleep study at home. That's the best way to kind of figure out what's going on in your sleep reality. They determined my problem, sinuses and nasal passages in my breathing triangle. They did a short procedure in office, 20 minutes, 25 minutes tops. I'm back to breathing better than ever. Great, great nights of sleep for my wife and myself. If you struggle like we did, take the time to see how Advent can help you. To find out how breathing well and sleeping well can make your nights better, go to AdventKnows.com and schedule an appointment today. Because Advent knows, when you breathe well, you live better.
The Midwest's best baseball and softball training facility and retail center is here in New Berlin, and it's ready for you and your team. From little leaguers to hardcore players and trainers, this is the place you'll want to be.
You can't beat Burkhart.
Hey, WTMJ's John Mercure here for one of my favorite places. The Fox and Hound Supper Club is the most unique, beautiful, and affordable dining destination in the area. Winners of the Top Choice Award for Fine Dining, Most Romantic Restaurant, and Best Sunday Brunch. When you buy one dinner, your second dinner is free always, 7 nights a week. Steak, seafood, ribs, pasta, big fresh salad, even the steak and lobster. Any dinner on the menu, your second dinner is free. That includes prime rib on Wednesdays and Saturdays. Desserts are also always buy one, get one free, and they're delicious. Relax with a hand-muddled old-fashioned, 20 bourbons, 100 wines, and one of their 8 elegant dining rooms. The Fox and Hound sits in the Kettle Moraine Forest, a spectacular setting. Celebrate a birthday, anniversary, or a quiet dinner with your love, and your second dinner is free. just off Highway 167, 2 miles east of Holy Hill. The drive is beautiful. Reserve at foxandhoundsrestaurant.com for your free dinner. Tonight, it's the Fox and Hounds.
My guest on this second half of the 9 o'clock hour, 9 to 10 political power hour on WTMJ, Jeremy Janine, president and co-founder of Urban Walk, is some great reporting on our community. And we just did his breaking news story on the DPW workers who were stealing essentially from the taxpayers and taking some of that money. Wonder how they did at Pottawatomie with that cash. Did we ever find that out? Did they win?
We'll find out based on their restitution payments.
Right. That's an interesting, I wonder if that's happened before, right? It has to have happened before. People steal money. There was a council member. Didn't somebody else get involved in this at one point?
Tony Clark on the county board.
That's what it was.
That was a little bit more than a decade ago now.
Yeah.
I forget exactly what she was doing, but it was criminal, so I assume it was campaign finance related.
It was against the law. All right. What else are you working on?
I yesterday reported on a story about what I call the free speech zone for the RNC.
What is that exactly?
And so many people would tell you that all of America is a free speech zone. That's what the First Amendment is for. And yes, absolutely true. But there's the security perimeter coming for the RNC. And so within that, there is a legal accepted standard of sight and sound of the convention itself. It seems like it's shaping up that in Milwaukee, that's going to mean Pierre Marquette Park to Pfizer Forum, a couple blocks away. And there'll be an amplified stage. The city will be supplying the amplification, so it won't be bring your own megaphone. And then there'll be a parade route, and you're going to get probably left-wing groups. You're going to get right-wing groups. You're going to get all kinds of people of different viewpoints. And the city is establishing a process where outside of the security zone, carry on as you normally would in Milwaukee for a protest or a parade, get the special permit, don't do whatever you normally do. Within the security zone, you got to sign up. And there's a group called the Coalition to March on the RNC. They've been working on this for 2 years. They testified yesterday that they don't like this. They think it's not really within sight and sound. It's too far from the door of Pfizer Forum. They also think it's too restrictive, that it should favor local groups. Lots of concerns they have. They did pledge that basically regardless of what the city does, they will sue in federal court.
There's always lawsuits, always lawyers. I asked I did some podcast recording the last couple of weeks on politics, and I asked both guests about expectations for protest. Now, I'm not saying it's Chicago 1968, because the Democrats are going to be in Chicago again this summer after the convention here. Like, what are you hearing? Like, this group obviously is not happy with the way it's laid out, but I'm hearing a lot of rumbling. There will be a lot of people showing up at this thing who are not invited guests.
Yeah, there'll be two very different things happening. There'll be the secured free speech zone where you'll have a permitted process as long as it withstands the legal challenges to be on the stage for a set time. I don't expect anything remotely resembling violence there. There were some concerns, from council members, what is this administration doing to secure this police department? But it sounds like that's pretty well handled. It's within the zone that the Secret Service is going to be heavily involved in securing. Then there is everything else that can possibly happen. And I think we saw in the city of Milwaukee in particular in 2020 that the protest movement that marched all over the city can happen in a quite peaceful mode. We also saw that same summer in Kenosha that all chaos can break loose, and it's unclear what. I mean, it's clear what instigated the protest, but why was there violence? What was different between Kenosha and Milwaukee? And I would suspect people should have major questions about what might happen outside of the security zone.
Yeah, and there's even questions on the security side, and I've been kind of tapping into some sources on that there's still some open questions, and there's resources being tapped that's actually taking away from some of the surrounding communities. They can't host events in their community, including 4th of July stuff, because they're going to be involved getting ready for this convention. So that's an underreported story. Another underreported story, I'm going to give you a tip for the future. We have a president, former president, who's going to be the nominee, accept the nomination in Milwaukee. He doesn't have a lot of money right now. The RNC doesn't have a lot of money, but they want to stage a big party. And certainly conventions are always under that classification. They're big events. The underreported story, or the future to be reported story, is there's going to be, if he does this, he'll put on the show. Those clients, those partners won't be paid. That's the unreported story in advance.
because he has a history of not paying his vendors.
Yeah, this has come up. A lot of readers have been asking about it. There is, to the city's security costs, and that's the 4,000 police officers that are going to come in, and you just hinted at the kind of the ramifications for suburban communities.
Which are real, by the way.
Yeah, very real. That grant, that is covered by a federal grant. That's a longstanding practice.
Yeah, it was like $75 million, something like that.
Between 50 and 75. Right. Congress is hashing that out right now, but that covers separate grants for both the DNC and the RNC. Longstanding practice. There's the local host committee. They pay Fiserv Forum and the different actual convention venues for rentals. But then there's this whole private ecosystem of Idaho for Trump rents out the ballroom at the rave. And who pays that bill?
That's or does it get paid?
Exactly.
Because this former president, let's be honest, has a history of not paying his vendors. That's why there's lawsuits. That's why I look to that as an underreported story now that may be a real story after the convention. You got to do this again.
Absolutely.
Yeah, Jeremy Janine, president and founder?
Co-founder.
Co-founder. Of Urban Walkie. Great local reporting. And I was happy that you broke the story last night and you came on the show this morning, because the DPW and that related story with the Pottawatomie Casino is where they spent that money is fascinating from a Milwaukee perspective. So thanks for sharing that story.
Thanks for having me.
All right, Jeremy Janine, my guest. We'll take a break here. We'll wrap up the Political Power Hour for this Tuesday. That's all next.
This is WTMJ's Sandy Max with a brand new show called What's on Tap. Weeknights at 6, you're invited to join me to take a deeper dive into culture and creativity here in Wisconsin and around the world. Tap into all kinds of entertainment and recreation with me, from music, theater, film, food, and uniquely Wisconsin traditions and landmarks. So pique your curiosity and join me for What's on Tap. And be sure to catch the podcast on your favorite podcast platform.
Hey, this is WTMJ Steve Scafidi for Universal Windows Direct. I've been telling you that windows from Universal perform better, last longer. Super spacer technology, that's the reason. Keeps the edge of the glass warmer, holds the window seal longer. Why does that matter? Makes the windows last up to 5 times longer than other window systems. But let's talk about some of the other things Universal does, their offers. You get a new home at the same address with new vinyl siding from Universal Windows Direct. Their exclusive Unishield Supreme siding delivers warm, quality appearance of wood without the costly, time-consuming maintenance and repairs. It won't rot, peel, or split. And because it's color blended in the panel, it never needs to be scraped, stained, or painted. Tell them I told you to call. Get an additional $250 off your project for the last windows you'll ever need. Do what I did. Go to UniversalWindowsDirect.com like me. UniversalWindowsDirect.com. You'll be saying, I love my windows.
Unless the grain of wheat falls to the ground and dies, it remains just a grain of wheat. But if it dies, it produces much fruit. Hello, this is Archbishop Lestecki. Jesus is the very bread of life. Like the grain of wheat, he suffers and dies so that we might live with him forever. The Eucharist is real food, multiplying his love in all of us. It's Lent. Join us at Mass.
Eager to remodel your kitchen, bath, or rec room? This is Rob Adair, and we're ready with a personal redesign for you. Adair Floors and Remodeling in Franklin. Give us a call and get personal care from Adair. 761-3660. AdairFloors.com.
Griffin is your one-stop shop this March. For just $179.95, enjoy an oil change, tire rotation, air filter, wiper blades, multi-point inspection, battery check, and heat inspection. North, south, or west, wherever you are in town, Griffin guarantees to cover your automotive needs. Call or visit us today for details and restrictions. Griffin, your spring drive starts here.
Since 1946, Ansay & Associates has provided insurance to help secure businesses and families throughout Wisconsin. With custom coverage and superior customer service, Ansay & Associates can provide all of your insurance needs. Visit ansay.com today and get a free consultation with one of our strategists. Or come see us in person at any of our local offices. Ansay & Associates, securing and protecting your American dream.
Why are people saying Hugh Yeah to Jackson Hewitt? Find out before it's too late. Hurry into Jackson Hewitt today.
WTMJ, W277CV, and WKTI HD2 Milwaukee. From the Annex Wealth Management Studios, this is News Radio WTMJ, a Good Karma brand station.
Wrapping up the Tuesday edition of Political Power Hour. Tomorrow on tomorrow's show, Andy Schwartz, of course. We got to actually have a truncated public safety hour because I'm going to bring on my friend Josh Shulman, County Executive, Washington County, at 9:30. So Andy gets a half hour, Josh will get a half hour. And, of course, the legal edition on Thursday. I always look forward to it. So this week, former Supreme Court Justice Jeanine Gieske, Attorney Tom Kuzmanovic, and that'll be a fun conversation because there's a lot of things happening in the legal side of politics. And, of course, the guys that started it all, the Political Power Hour, creators, founders, and political strategist extraordinaire, Bill McCosh on the Republican side, Joseph Pecky on the left, hashing out all the week's news in politics. My show poll quickly before we get to the top of the hour news here. So I asked the question, it's going to be a big relevant story next week. The president is saying, and his team is saying, they can't come up with the bond money. $454 million, I think, is the number. And it grows every day. I think it's $80,000 or something. It grows every day with interest. Can't come up with the cash. So that's one question. And at this moment, it doesn't seem like it's going to happen. And people are now starting to ask, well, I thought this guy was rich. What's going on? Well, if you have assets that are in property and things, you have two choices. Somebody will bond you the money with those as collateral, or two, you sell them. And the alternative, of course, if he doesn't do that, these assets could be seized. And that would be a really big story because we're talking about a candidate's presumptive nominee at this moment, nominee certainly in July at the convention, Donald Trump. So I asked a different question. Do you think him saying that he can't come up with the money, is he telling the truth here? I gave you a few choices. Unreasonable, 23% of you said that. We're already at almost 250 votes. No, he's a liar, 27%. And the leader on the course, soon to be a leader in the clubhouse, don't care either way, 41, let's say 42%. That's telling to me. That indicates political apathy, right? Voter maybe disinterest in some of this stuff, which is not surprising given all the things swirling around the former president, that's the story. I don't want to hear about it. I just want to vote. Well, we'll find out what happens, of course, in the next that we have here. To the election, 8 months. All right, news is next. Thanks for listening to the Political Power Hour on WTMJ.
Increase in taxes while families are paying more for everything from gas to groceries is wrong. Milwaukee voters should oppose increase in property taxes by nearly 30% in order to provide increased funding yet again to Milwaukee public schools. They've already wasted nearly $1 billion in new taxpayer funding, and now they want more? They don't even have a plan on how they'll spend it. Enough is enough. Milwaukee voters should just say no.
Paid for by Enough is Enough. Vote no.
Hey, this is WTMJ, Steve Scafidi for Annex Wealth Management. When it comes to your investment and retirement plan, this is not a time to set it and forget it, especially with the Fed in limbo and the upcoming presidential election. This is a time to be nimble. It's time for Annex Wealth Management. Know where you are, where you can go based on working with Annex. Retirement investment planning, tax planning, estate planning, that's what Annex does. If you're already retired, good for you. How about a second look at your current plan? Same thing with do-it-yourselfers. Annex can help you get across the finish line. The Annex financial planning team takes everything into account and charts a path forward for you. It's a great chance to know the difference with a fee-only fiduciary. It's easy. Go to annexwealth.com. That's what I did. And click the now famous Get Started button every day. People just like you visiting one of their 8 branches or meeting via Zoom. I've done it both ways. They both are fantastic. Know the difference. Start at annexwealth.com.
Cashback is not available on gas in New Jersey and Wisconsin.
Susan, it's so great to finally be able to get to